This is the only folk song I ever researched. I learned this from my grandmother. She told me she'd learned it from a friend of hers, and I went and met her. She's about 105 years old now. She learned it from her brother, who was 110, and I went and met him. You know, he lived north of Fort Worth, and he learned it from me. And it's called, the Dollar Bill Blues. If I had a dollar bill, yes, I believe I surely will go to town and drink my fill early in the morning. Little darling, she's a redhead thing, man, she makes my legs to sing. Gonna buy her a diamond ring early in the morning. Well, long way down the Harlan Road, busted back in a heavy load, won't get through to save my soul early in the morning. Always been a gambling man, rolling bones with either hand, 7 years to promised land early in the morning. Well, whiskey be my dying bed, tell me where can I lay my head, not with me is all she said early in the morning. If I had a dollar bill, yes, I believe I surely will go to town and drink my fill early in the morning. Well, if I had a dollar bill, yes, I believe I surely will go to town and drink my fill early in the morning. Fill early in the morning.
Thanks.
Thanks, I'll play one more talking kind of song. This is by a guy named Peter Lafarge, who was a folk singer, died about 63 or 64. Everybody knows songs. It's called The Ballad of Ira Hayes. I'll just play it. Well, come gather around me, people. A story I'd like to tell about a brave young Indian that you should remember well. From a tribe of Pima Indians, a proud and noble band that farmed the Phoenix Valley down in Arizona land. Well, down the ditches for 10,000 years, the sparkling waters rushed. And the white man stole the water rights, and all the running water's hushed. Now Ira's folks go hungry, and their farms grow crops of weeds. When war came, Ira volunteered, forgot the white man's greed. You call him drunken Ira Hayes, he can't answer anymore. Not the whiskey-drinking Indian, the Marine that went to war. They battled up Iwo Jima Hill, 250 men. Only 27 lived to walk back down again. And when that fight was over, when Old Glory raised, well, among the men that held her high was the Indian Ira Hayes. You call him drunken Ira Hayes, he can't answer anymore. Not the whiskey drinking Indian, the Marine that went to war. Well, Ira came back a hero. He was celebrated throughout the land. He was wined and speeched and honored. Everybody shook his hand. But he was just a Pima Indian, Had no money, no home, no chance. In Arizona, no one cared what Ira had done. Because when did the Indians dance? And so Ira started drinking hard in jail, was often his home. They let him raise the flag and lower it like you'd throw a dog a bone. Well, he died drunk early one morning, all alone in this land he'd fought to save. 2 inches of water in a lonesome ditch was a grave for Ira Hayes. Call him drunken Ira Hayes, he won't answer anymore. Not the whiskey-drinking Indian, the Marine that went to war. Yeah, call him drunken Ira Hayes, but his land is still as dry, and his ghost is lying thirsty inside the ditch where Ira died.
Thanks. Good song, huh?
Thanks. I'll play this one. It's called If I Needed You. Thanks, Mom, Uncle Jeff. Thanks. If I needed you, would you come to me? Would you come to me and ease my pain? If you needed me, I would come to you. I'd swim the seas for to ease your pain. Well, in the night forlorn, all the morning's born, and the morning shines with the lights of love. You will miss sunrise if you close your eyes, and that would break my heart in two. Lady's with me now, since I showed her how to lay her lily hand in mine. Loop and Lil agree, she's a sight to see and a treasure for the poor to find. If I needed you, would you come to me? Would you come to me and ease my pain? If you needed me, I would come to you. I'd swim the seas for to ease your pain.
I played a song when I was in school. I had a couple. I pledged two different fraternities, you know, different times, right? And I never went active, you know. But I wrote a song about it. Right after when I started playing, the first places I played were fraternity parties, so I figured I'd have a song about it, and I wrote this song and played it at one, and then I had to start doing clubs, right? Well, I decided to improve my social station. I joined a fraternal organization. tucked in my shirt, signed on the line. Right away they set about to improve my mind, my breath, my friends, my friends' breath. Said, kid, we don't much like the way you walk, and you're gonna have to change the way you talk. Said, your dress is kind of slouchy and your attitude's mighty grouchy. Said, you got to learn to bubble. You got to bubble with enthusiasm, and I started bubbling. Well, now the most important thing you can't forget is learning the entire Greek alphabet. I never really did understand how that's going to make me any more a man, but I learned it. I can whip through that son of a beta backwards in 5 seconds. Well, then he hit me with some pretty bad news concerning the payment of monthly dues. I never did know where that money went, and I never was sure it was real well spent, but I paid it. I ain't no trouble causer, and besides, I figured that's life. If you want good friends, they're gonna cost you. Finally got to be party time. I got me a great big old jug of wine. I went back to the house in about an hour, and everybody's drinking whiskey sours, brandy Alexanders, frozen daiquiris, reciting the Greek alphabet to one another. Like, see, I was gonna have to do my very best to get myself out of that fraternity mess. I stood right there outside the door, and I chugged that wine like never before. Went inside and bubbled all over a couple of their dates. Yes, and everything's back to normal again, but there's still lots of room for improvement, friend. Of course, that fraternity stuff's too much for me. Next time I'm gonna join a sorority. Really give them something to bubble about.
Back to where I came.
That old white freightliner's gonna haul away my freight. Going out on a highway, listen to them big trucks whine, whine, whine. I'm going out on a highway, listen to them big trucks whine. White freightliner, won't you steal away my mind? Red white freightliner, won't you steal away my mind?
Play this, this is a pretty waltz called Don't Take It Too Often. Don't Take It Too Bad. Well, don't you take it too bad if you're feeling unloving. Well, if you're feeling unfeeling, if you're feeling alone, don't you take it too bad, 'cause it ain't you to blame, babe. Well, it's some kind of game made out of all of this living that we got left to do. Oh, and if you go searching for rhyme or for reason, well, you won't have the time that it takes just for talking about the places you've been, babe, about the faces you've seen, babe. Oh, and how soft the time flies past your window at night. And we just can't have that girl. It's a hard, lonesome, cold world, and a man needs a woman all to stand by his side and whisper sweet words in his ears about daydreams and roses and playthings and the sweetness of springtime and the sound of the rain.
Thanks.
Well, y'all been such a great audience, I'm gonna let you in on something. I know where, not very many people know this, I know where there's a goat for sale, cheap. I'm talking about cheap. Just talk to any of us after the show. It's a great goat, $300. Great goat. Lays golden eggs. I'll see if I can, I'll play another talking blues song. Fire. I think I can remember it. Well, I ain't very big for 21. Seems like I never could have any good clean fun. Every time I went outside, some great big old bully would come along. Kicked me in the face and knocked me to the ground, start to hit me all around. I tell you, that ain't exactly fair, friends, that's wrong. So I got me a paper the other night. I crawled up on the sofa and I flipped on the light. I turned through the pages till I found the classified ads. It says, take karate from Lee Hung Chow. Man, make your first appointment now. This course is guaranteed to make you bad. Well, next day I drove to the address by the Japanese designer. I was real impressed. Looked like a regular house of the rising sun. Went inside, I was all alone. I had a nervous feeling down in my bones. Kinda sorry I'd ever even come. And a giant Jap comes through the door. I swear he was 7'4" and he looked like he's prone to easy aggravation. He said, "Lee Hung Chow, Aiki Dung, that's Japanese for fee, fi, fo, fum." I tried to explain my entire situation. He said, "Number one course, Yankee self-defense, $200.75. I said, "What's the 75 cents for?" And he said, "Repairs." I said, "Repairs to what?" And he said, "To you." And I thought, great God, that'll never do. I felt about a half inch tall underneath that crooked stare. You think he was yellow? I said, "I believe I'll go try another place." He said, "Ah, so Yankee don't like my race." I said, "Now there's a mistake, man, and that's true. I've been for you Japanese all along. You Japanese can't do no wrong, and I thought you got a pretty dirty deal in World War II. Well, he grabbed me by the hand and gave a heave, and I figured there's a pretty good time to leave before he had a chance to do me any definite harm. My plan worked out in the end, you see. Now no bully's gonna pick on me. Who's gonna hit a fella with just one arm? Play this song. I learned this song from a long time ago out of an Elvis Presley movie called King Creole. They played this on a shrimp boat. You know, the scene was on a shrimp boat going off into the sunset, right? And the guys in the back were playing the oil cans and stuff. Well, I saw three shrimp in the water. Two were old and gray. I swam a little bit closer and I heard the third one say, "Goodbye, mommy shrimp, papa shake my hand. Here comes a shrimp boat for to take me Louisiana." He showed his mama and papa a shrimp newspaper he'd read, with an advertisement which to all the young shrimp said, "Free ride, New Orleans, stay in Grand Hotel. Meet Creole gal to help you to come out of your shell. Meet Creole gal to help you to come out of your shell." His poor mama and papa, well, ain't heard from him yet. Last time they saw his smiling face was when he jumped into the net. "Goodbye, mommy shrimp, papa shake my hand. Here comes a shrimp boat for to take me Louisiana. Here comes a shrimp boat for to take me Louisiana." Play a couple more. This is a blues song. Can't play a set without playing a blues song. It's a Lightning Hopkins song. I kind of learned to play a guitar from listening to his records, you know. I used to lock myself up in an apartment with one of his records and a case of Bally High. Right? You can't learn to play a guitar that way, man. You can't learn at all. Thank you.
I start, it won't start this morning. Man, my engine won't even turn. My starter won't start this morning. Man, my engine won't even turn, turn. I've been running with a fast class of women, and they have caused my little car to ruin. Man, my starter won't start this morning. I hope ain't nothing wrong with my little machine. My starter won't start this morning. I hope ain't nothing wrong with my little machine. Mechanic said your car's all right, kid. You just been burning bad gasoline. My starter won't start this morning. Man, my engine won't even turn. My starter won't start this morning. Man, my engine won't even turn, turn. I've been running with a fast class of women, and they have caused my little car to ruin.